Now, about what I know of my master. I belong to south of India. I was born in a traditional Orthodox Indian family where my parents were great scholars in the scriptures and traditional education. My father knows all the Vedas and their commentaries. He's a great scholar in all the Vedas and all the commentaries. He was a great scholar in Ayurveda and who has conducted many miraculous cures. And he was also a scholar in the traditional medicine and homeopathy. And he had many disciples in the scriptures. He was a great master in yoga. He practiced yoga with his master. He lived with his master for 12 years. He had the power to cure diseases by touch and meditation. From my childhood, I received traditional education at home. When I was about 5 years of age, I was just learning English alphabet, the Roman alphabet, and I saw a little book with my father, and on the outer cover of the book, I saw big letters, CVE, and because I was just learning the alphabet, I took pride in reading the letters aloud. And my father said, it is the name of a great master. And he has opened the book and shown me a picture. It was the same picture. He said, this is the name of that master. And he also said, it is a mantram to be meditated. That was what happened in my 5th year. Automatically, I forgot everything afterwards. I didn't remember anything of it at all. And when I was studying in the university, that is about after 16 years interval, I visited a gathering in a house. All of them were sitting like this together, and there was a big picture of the master before them. I did not remember the picture I saw with my father, but I felt that I have seen him. I thought that it was some friend of my father. And then all of them, they were sitting in closed eyes and meditation. I also sat with them. After a few minutes, we dispersed and I forgot everything about it. Afterwards, after 3 more years, it is when I was about 21 years, an old gentleman took me to a gathering. There were many people gathering in a big hall, and there was the picture of the master there. I felt that I have seen him somewhere.
Sentivo de haberlo visto de cualquier parte.
Because I did not remember the previous scenes. And they were all closing their eyes. I too closed my eyes. And they were all doing like this. I did like that. And one of them said, Namaskarams, Master CV. And I too repeated with others. And then I found some change going on in my body. There was a peculiar sensation in my spine, like a feeble electric current. See, when we touch an electric current, there will be a peculiar sensation. I felt the same sensation in my column. I was enjoying it, closing my eyes. It was continuously going on for a few minutes. I wanted to open my eyes. I could not do it. And after some time, the sensation stopped. I opened my eyes. All the other people also opened their eyes. And immediately we had good lunch and then we discussed them. I asked the old gentleman who took me there what it is. He said, they are all some yoga practitioners. And he said, I don't believe in all these things. They are all, he said, foolish. They believe in many things. And because there was good lunch, I took you there, he said.
E come c'era un buon pranzo, son venuto.
So, I could not get any information from him. Then, I forgot about it. And then, in 1949, I completed my post-graduation course and I joined my service as a professor in a college. I had to make my own residence separately and I was newly married. I had to bring my wife. So I rented a house and brought my wife. Since we belong to the traditional family, we wanted to establish a meditation room for ourselves. I went to the market and purchased a beautiful picture of Gayatri. And then I started my meditation room with Gayatri picture. And daily in the morning, it is our habit to sing Gayatri mantra. From childhood, we are taught like that. So we started there in our shrine room. After about a month days, when I sat down, saw the picture of Gayatri and closed my eyes, I saw a different picture. I saw the lower portion of this picture. That is, somebody sitting only the lower portion. I thought it was some illusion of the mind. Because we see many things many times, the mind is strange. And as long as I was closing my eyes and chanting Gayatri, I was seeing only that picture without a change. I thought it was some illusion. The next day in the morning again, I saw the same picture a little above. I felt something strange. Because it is not usual to see the same picture when we close the eyes. And the next day I saw it a little above. After a few days I saw it a little above. And finally, I saw the whole picture. Then I suspected that it was not wild imagination, because there is some continuity in it. It was very calm in the morning. Every day we sit for meditation in India before sunrise. And since the room was a separate shrine room for ourselves, it was quite calm and I was enjoying the same picture daily. I opened my eyes and saw Gayatri, and I closed my eyes, I saw this picture. Of course, I didn't question into the matter too much, but I was just enjoying it passively. Because there's no use of questioning anymore. We don't get any answers to our questions. And after I enjoyed the same picture for about 2.5 weeks, I was invited to visit a village high school. The headmaster of the high school invited me to his place to celebrate the centenary celebrations of Rabindranath Tagore. And I went to his place that evening. It was about 5:30 in the evening. We were sitting and talking many things. Suddenly he said, it is 6 o'clock. You would excuse me for a few minutes. We have a prayer inside. We'll conduct our prayer and again come and join you, he said. He asked me to wait for about 15 minutes. I said, yes. He went into his house. An idea came to my mind. Why can't I also go and join the prayer? But I felt a little bit delicate. He came back again and said, if you have no objection, you come and join us in the prayer. You see, if we can understand, it is how the master's grace will flow to us. Had he not invited me, I would have felt delicate. So I went inside, and his wife and children were sitting in a row, and I saw a big picture of the master, a human-sized picture painting. I felt really shocked, because this is the same fellow whom I am seeing in the morning daily. He comes to my house without invitation in the morning, and I sat there, followed what they did. They closed their hands like this, they closed their eyes, and they repeated Namaskaram Master CVV 3 times. I too repeat. Immediately there was a peculiar sensation in the spine, exactly the same sensation which I had previously. And immediately it came to my mind that previously I had the same sensation, and I could recollect that this is the second time that I am sitting for this prayer. Then I recollected that it was not the second time but the third time, because the recollection went back, and finally I recollected that at the age of about 5, I saw these letters on the book, on the picture, and I could correctly recollect that I have seen the picture in the hands of my father. That is what I experienced when I sat in the meditation. And after 15 minutes, we got up and then asked him who the master was. Then he said, he is called Master CVV. We invoke his name in 3 letters daily. We do this 2 times in the day, that is 6 in the morning and 6 in the evening. And that he was a great guru of the Raja Yoga path, and that he had many disciples, and he lived in South India, about 200 miles from Madras, in the banks of a holy river called Kaveri. And he was having his own yoga school. He passed away before 6 years before I was born. So after he passed away, I was born 6 years later. So there was no possibility for me to go and see him physically. So I asked the gentleman to give me his inscription of the name of the master, along with his signature and acceptance for me to repeat the master's name. I wanted to form a link with the master through this gentleman, because without the link of a living person, there will be no use of any mantra. We should receive a mantra only through a person, not through a book. Just as you should learn music only from a person, not from a book. So he has given me in my diary the name of the master, and he made his signature and date. And from that day, I began to meditate upon the master's name daily. And he also informed me that there was a photographer at Madras who was a direct disciple of the master, and the photographer was too old. He was about 92 years. And if I wrote to him, he will send me a photo of the master. He advised me to write immediately, because he has grown too old. You may have the luck in getting the picture through him. So I returned home. I was lazy enough not to write to him. But within 5 days, I got a picture of the master through post, because the gentleman has written to him to send me a picture. And I opened the packet when I received it through post and saw on the back the signature of the photographer also. And when I was looking at the photo of the master, some friend brought a newspaper. I read the news that the old man left his physical body. It was strange. And I took that photo, and from that picture, I multiplied all these pictures. That is how it started. And then, when I was meditating upon the master daily, I began to see some colors and some pictures, and for about a few weeks I just enjoyed the see pictures, and then I felt like having a book to note all these things with dates. So I started with my spiritual diary, and I began to get some passages
in English,
some in my own language, some in Telugu, some in Sanskrit, like that. I noted them as they came to me. Sometimes there are some symbols and some figures, some numbers, like that. And in course of time, I came to understand that I am getting my program of the day as instructions. And since then, life took a very peculiar turn. I came into contact with most remarkable people, and I could never imagine that I will travel the world for such a great distance. Because as I told you, I was not rich, and I am not rich even now. I live only just self-sufficient, that's all. And as a language professor, I have no possibility to travel other country. But there was a spiritual society in my place who started a spiritual monthly journal, and they wanted me to be the editor of the journal. I started doing it. They used to send the journal to Adyar Madras Theosophical Society, and one old gentleman was going through my editorials in the journal. Yeah, he was reading. And he has written to me a letter. I was following your editorials. I want to have a correspondence with you. That old gentleman was a native of Belgium. Belgium, that is a village called Spontain. And he was living temporarily in South India, doing some research in the Theosophical Society area. And he made a correspondence with me. And after about a year of correspondence, he felt much satisfied with my explanations of the scriptures. As soon as he began to make a contact with me, the journal in my place stopped. They could not continue the journal. But we continued our correspondence. And then he invited me to his place in the Nilgiris, that is Blue Mountains in South India. And for 1 month, I was giving discourses in his place about the scriptures and spiritual astrology. Then he gave me the first set of books written by Alice Bailey. Until then, I did not know who Alice Bailey was. It was he who first introduced Alice Bailey to me. My father was the first who introduced Blavatsky to me. I have read the books of Blavatsky with my father, with his good explanations. But this was the first time for me to see the books of Alice Bailey. And it was remarkable that was the first set that came to India at all. So, I was the first man who received the first set of Alice Bailey books in India. And then I began to read them. He wanted me to explain certain passages. And he said that he was thoroughly satisfied with my explanations of Alice Bailey books, especially Cosmic Fire and Initiation. And he took my lectures in cassettes. And after I returned to my place, he wanted me to prepare a textbook of what I taught to him. So I prepared a book called Spiritual Astrology, and I sent the script to him. Immediately he got it typed, and he got it printed in South India, and he took the books and the cassettes of my lectures to Belgium. He had his disciples in Belgium, France and Switzerland, and he has distributed my lectures and books and introduced my name to those places. His name was Mr. Albert Cecil. Still there are his disciples in these countries. For the first time they invited me to Europe in 1972. That is how it started. So after I started meditated my master's name, all these things became possible for me. Another peculiar experience of mine is, I was trying to understand secret doctrine after I started meditating his name. Of course, it was very difficult. Even though my father explained everything, it was not easy. One night, some gentleman just asked me on the street, "Are you reading secret doctrine?" I was shocked. I was just thinking what to answer. Again he repeated, "Are you reading secret doctrine?" I said, "I am trying to understand." Then immediately he said, "You read from this particular chapter and page. There is a chapter named The Holy of the Holies and Its Degradation, Sanctum Sanctorum." He asked me to start from that page and read, you will understand, he said. It was late in the night and he said, and he went away. Just I tried to follow him, but I could not find him anymore. I went home and started reading secret doctrine from that page. I began to understand things which I could not understand previously. And also I found a great commotion and activity going on in all the whole body. And strangely, I was only alone in my house during those days. My wife and other people, they were away in some other town. I was single in my house in the night. I was reading these books secret that I felt some activity going on in the house. I suspected or imagined that some people are walking here and there. And I found something like a fog before my eyes, like a screen. And I found many people coming and going. I saw many forests and many temples and many pyramids. And people with peculiar garments going and coming. Having lengthy garments, some people having turbans, and some people having some barbs and all that. And late in the night I was reading the book. The next day I wished I would see the gentleman once again. So late in the night again I went into the street, anticipating that I may see him. It was about 2 a.m. and I saw him again. Very lucky. He asked me, "Have you attempted to read it?" I said, "Yes."
See?
Okay. And then he gave me a picture on a paper. He said, "Daily meditate upon this picture and then you read the book, you will understand." He said, "You read Bhagavad Gita also." I said, I have read Bhagavad Gita. Then he said, "No, read it again." Then I understood that I was a fool to answer like that.
Ho capito che era stato uno sciocco per rispondergli.
And I asked him if I can know his address. He smiled and said, "No, we will be meeting." That's all what he said. Then I used my intelligence and said, "You are welcome to my house." Then he said, "No, when the time comes, we meet again." So I wanted to lead him by the nose to my house. And it was not possible. There was nothing mysterious about him. But again and again, he is appearing to me. And from time to time, he is advising me and helping me in everything. And after some time I was shocked to see him in a different place also when I went to another city or town or country. I see him in every country, but I don't find anything peculiar. But I receive every bit of program of my life from him. And he has explained me many things. And I think many of the things which I explain in my conferences, they are the things given by him to me. And he said, this is the only thing which you can do. That is the meditation of the master. And he promised me one thing. That is, if you want to ask anything, don't ask anyone, you ask me. Then you will have no necessity to ask for anything. And if you observe this principle, you will find that everything comes to you without asking. That is what he said. And I began to observe that principle since 35 years. And during these 35 years, I had no necessity to ask anyone for anything till today, including my bread and my house and my family maintenance.